Hi everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel Dr. Srinivas Medical Concepts and my FB page Dr. Srinivas Concepts. This is Dr. Srinivas, neurologist from Andhra Pradesh, India. I am also the medical author of the book Focused Neurology. Today we are going to talk about a very interesting topic, the differentiation between focal seizure, transient ischemic attack and migraine. Since they occur paroxysmally, sometimes it is very difficult to differentiate a focal seizure from a transient ischemic attack from migraine. So if we go methodically, we will be able to differentiate the focal seizure, transient ischemic attack and migraine. So let's see what are all the steps wherein if we go methodically, we can differentiate. First, the onset. The focal seizure, the progression of symptoms is over seconds. Person is all right, suddenly he develops a focal seizure and it progresses over seconds. Whereas in transient ischemic attack, there is a sudden onset of a focal neurological deficit. So transient ischemic is a sudden onset of a focal neurological deficit. And migraine, the progression of symptoms gradually starts escalating. Over 15 to 20 minutes, it slowly starts building up and it can go up to for a few hours. So it is gradual in onset. Migraine, it is gradual in onset over a few minutes. Transient ischemic attack is a sudden onset of a focal neurological deficit. In focal seizure, the progression of symptoms is over seconds. The symptoms. So what are all the symptoms of focal seizure, transient ischemic attack and migraine? When we see the focal seizures, the symptoms, the motor symptoms are positive. That is, usually they'll have tonic-clonic involvement. If the motor cortex is involved, there is tonic-clonic involvement. So they are positive symptoms. Likewise, if there is sensory, there'll be hyperesthesia. There'll be hyperesthesia, excessive perception of sensations, hyperesthesia. And when it involves the temporal lobe, they can have an altered sensorium, deja vu and jamesio phenomenon, familiarity with unfamiliar surroundings or unfamiliarity with familiar surroundings. So they can have a positive motor symptoms, positive sensory symptoms and positive psychological state like deja vu and jamesio phenomenon. Whereas in transient ischemic attack, the symptoms are negative, motor symptoms are negative, they'll have weakness. So it will be there, generally they will have hemiplegia. Likewise, the sensory symptoms are also negative, they will have hemisthesia. And visual, they will have homonymous hemianopia, negative. So motor, sensory and visual, they are negative. They are hemiparesis, hemisthesia and homonymous hemianopia. Migraine, the symptoms are basically visual, they will have visual aura. It starts building up slowly, they will have classic scintillating scotomas. So scintillating scotomas are positive, are characteristic of migraine, the symptoms. So these are the symptoms which we see in these three disorders. The duration. Focal seizures, they usually last less than few minutes. Focal seizures usually last less than few minutes. Transient ischemic attack, by definition, the symptoms last less than 24 hours, but what we commonly see is that it lasts less than 1 hour. So transient ischemic attack, the symptoms usually last less than 24 hours, but what we see clinically most of the time is the symptoms last less than 1 hour. Migraine, the symptoms slowly starts building up over a few minutes and it goes for at least few hours, 4 hours. So this is about the duration. Consciousness. Consciousness is because of the reticular activating system. So when the brainstem is involved, where the RAS is very close together, or in cortices, they spread bilaterally, centrifugally. So for a person to lose consciousness, either the RAS system, the brainstem should get affected, or both the cortices should get affected. If one cortex gets affected, person does not lose consciousness. And therefore, in focal seizures, if it is confined only to one part of the cortex, they do not lose consciousness. But focal seizures, when it becomes generalized by spreading it to the other cortex through corpus callosum, and if both the cortices are involved, then the person loses consciousness. In transient ischemic attack, usually the consciousness is preserved, and in migraine, the consciousness is preserved. Headache. Focal seizures, they may usually have postictal headache. After the seizures, they'll have headache, postictal headache. In transient ischemic attack, it is usually absent because brain is by and large is insensitive to pain. You cut brain, there is no pain. But the meninges and the meningeal vessels are highly sensitive to pain. So if it is confined only to the cortex, there is no headache. But if the transient ischemic attack, the ischemic region spreads to involve the meninges, meningeal vessels, then they may develop headache. Migraine, they have classic headache. It is usually unilateral, a throbbing type of headache. So in focal seizures, they have postictal headache. Transient ischemic attack, if brain per se is involved, there is no headache, but if meninges are involved, they can get headache. And in migraine, there is a characteristic headache, which is unilateral and throbbing type of pain. The recovery, once they recover from focal seizures, once they recover, they usually have some amount of confusion, postictal confusion, or they may have weakness, postictal weakness, what we call it as Tots palsy, because of exhaustion and usage of nutrients. In transient ischemic attack, the recovery is usually rapid and usually complete. That's why we call it as a transient ischemic attack. Migraineous patient, they recover after severe headache, but then there may be some amount of fatigue. So they may feel weak, fatigue. Risk factors. The risk factor for focal seizures are usually structural. If it is generalized seizures, the reasons may be metabolic, like hypoglycemia, hyponatremia, or sometimes idiopathic without any cause. So generally, we need not definitely get the diagnosis by imaging. But focal seizures are usually due to a structural lesion. A part of the brain is affected. So focal seizures are because of structural impairment, and they are usually picked up by CT or MRI. So the risk factors are focal structural lesion for focal seizures. It could be neurocysticercosis, it could be tuberculoma, it could be abscess, it could be anything. A focal structural lesion is the risk factor for a focal seizure, development of focal seizure. For ischemic attack, the risk factors are the atherosclerotic risk factors, especially hypertension. Hypertension is the single most important modifiable risk factor for ischemic stroke. For myocardial infarction, dyslipidemia is the single most important modifiable risk factor. So very important. For ischemic stroke, hypertension is the single most important modifiable risk factor. For myocardial infarction, dyslipidemia is the single most important modifiable risk factor. The other risk factors for ischemic stroke are after hypertension, diabetes, hyperlipidemia, smoking, alcoholism, atrial fibrillation, or carotid artery stenosis or hypercoagulability. The risk factors for migraine are, migraine is usually a disorder of young. So usually we see in young age, persons who have crossed 40, for them it is unusual for them to develop a first attack of migraine. So usually it is a disease of the young. So young age is a risk factor for migraine. It is more common in women than men. So gender is a risk factor, women risk factor. The reactivity to stress. Everybody faces stress, but some of migraineous patients overreact to stress. So stress, young age, gender, and migraine runs in families also. So a family history is also a risk factor. Family history, young age, gender, that is women, and overreactivity to stress are the important risk factors for migraine. The treatment for focal seizures, the drug of choice is carbamazepine or oxcarbamazepine, the anti-epileptic drugs. For focal seizures, oxcarbamazepine and carbamazepine are the drugs of choice. For transient ischemic attack, we give antiplatelets as treatment. For migraine, we give non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents. If it is acute and severe, we give triptans. And for prophylactic therapy, we give tricyclic antidepressants like amitriptyline, beta blockers like propranolol, or calcium channel blockers like flunarizine. So, paroxysmal event, it could be a focal seizure, a transient ischemic attack, or migraine. And therefore, it may sometimes appear difficult to differentiate these three disorders. And therefore, if we go step by step, methodically, we'll be able to clinch the diagnosis. I hope you have enjoyed listening to my lecture. If you have any suggestions or comments, kindly post on to my YouTube channel. But please like and subscribe my YouTube channel, Dr. Srinivas Medical Concepts, and my FB page, Dr. Srinivas Concepts. Thank you. Bye.